Now we are going to see about the Squid installation and configuration. Squid is a free and open source full-featured package which is used as web proxy cat server, and this is also can be used in many ways like web server caching for speeding up the sites, and also uses cache DNS lookups. Squid is mainly used to set rules and restrictions to its client machine using its IP addresses. And now let me see about the Squid installation and the basic configuration. For Squid installation, apt-get install Squid. Yes, for further proceeding the installation. Now the installation is proceeding. Now the Squid installation is completed, and let me see about the configuration. The configuration file will be in the location va/etc/squid3 and squid.conf, and this is the Squid configuration file. First we have to see two basics configuration, that is the HTTP port and HTTP access. First let me see about HTTP port. Now press escape and friend slash and HTTP underscore port to search HTTP port and press enter. Now give N for next search, and here you can see HTTP port 3128. The default port of Squid is 3128, and you can change this port number for the security reasons. And the next one is HTTP access, the same, give escape, friend slash and HTTP underscore access and press enter, and again N for next search. Here you can see HTTP access denial. HTTP access deny means it blocks all the HTTP access to the Squid so that no internet connection or no connection is given through the Squid. So for accessing the Squid you have to give allow instead of deny. Press I for insert and edit this one. Hello. And now you can see here, insert your own rules here to allow access from your clients. So you have to enter your rules here in this space to allow your clients to access Squid. Now here you can see I have created a simple rule for 5.210 client. So this is the client IP, and this is a ACL access control list, and this is access control list name, and SRC for source IP, this is IP, and in the next line ACL block, this block is referred that destination domain. I have mentioned some domain inside this text file block.txt, let me check it later. And the next line is HTTP access deny. I have given a deny, and the next is new list, which is the access control list name I have mentioned here. And the next is the block. This consists of the domains to be blocked. And the next line is HTTP access allow new list. The same. This tells that the domain listed inside the text file block.txt will be only blocked, that is denied, and others will be allowed for this IP 192.168.5.210. And let me save it. Before that, let me copy the path and we can check the domain which we are going to block. I am saving it. The domain we have blocked is here. I have only mentioned facebook.com to block. So let me save this also and now reload the service. Squid 3, reload. Yes, now we can check. You can see the IP here first, 5.210, which we mentioned in the Squid configuration file. And now we are going to check the access. Before that, set in preferences, advanced, network settings. Here you can see manual proxy configurations. In manual proxy, I have mentioned the proxy IP and the port. I'll give OK. And now we are going to check. Oh, this is working. And when we give Facebook, it should be blocked. As you can see, the proxy server is refusing the connections. The next we are going to see is access log file. Access log is nothing but it shows the logs of the domain that is accessed by the client. So first let me access some domains in the client machine. And here is our client machine. Now I am giving Google and then I am giving Yahoo. And then I am giving Facebook. So Facebook is blocking for us. So let me check these access in the log file of Squid. So here is Squid log file, we can check it here. Cat slash var log squid 3 and access log. This is the default path for access log. So here you can see we have access to Google, which is connected, and Yahoo, this is also connected, and here you can see the Facebook is denied. The next is changing the default path of access log. You can change the default path of access log in the Squid configuration file. So we etc Squid 3 and Squid CONF. Now let me search for access log. Access underscore log. Here you can see the default path which we entered just before. You can edit this path and you can change it. Save it after you rename. After the every changes in the configuration file, don't forget to reload the service. Service Squid 3 reload. Thank you.